Hi guys, welcome to T3 Sprint. So we have six complexes for you, all designed to build your sport-specific fitness. And even if you don't play sport, these are fantastic for developing a range of fitness components and for burning loads of calories too. We should warm up, so we begin with our mobilization complex. It's one cycle through, 45 seconds per exercise. We'll take up a team formation and work through those movements. We are 25 seconds in, so let's keep it going. Let's try and get a little bit more speed in that sequence. Take a jog back. You've got 10 more seconds to go. Let's try and get one more in. Fantastic. Each time getting the height of the hip circle just that little bit more. So nice tight hip position, bringing the foot into the crease of the hip, gently pressing down on the inside of the knee and taking that into a drop lunge, remembering to always control the knee alignment over the foot. Looking good. Well done. Keep that little jog back in. As soon as there's space and the person in front has moved forward, you should start your exercise. So person behind, just wait for your partner. Now go. Fantastic. As soon as you see the person in front of you get to the back pedal halfway point, we can begin. Just got to be aware of not clashing. That shouldn't happen. Nice quick feet, nice bit of pace out, and off we go. Fantastic. We're now moving on to our stability complex. We have two cycles, it's constant time, and we're working for 30 seconds on each exercise. So perching on the right leg this time, knee over toes, pointing, tapping the ground, and continuing those reps for 30 seconds. Let's see how the guys are getting on. Okay, let's begin. So eyes are closed. We want to have just a little bit of knee bend on the support leg. And if you feel good and you can see your partner's performing well, we can explore the different spaces that we can take them in. If they lose balance, that's fine. Just reset and we get to go again. So we're looking for as many repetitions as possible, but without sacrificing balance and control. That knee should tuck in right behind the heel in a perfect line. So we're 10 seconds in. Let's keep going, team. Well done. Make sure the feet are on that same imaginary line. Person number one, let's make it you, Jonathan, to start. Let's go. Good plank pickup and then straight into your start position once again. Good, next person, go. Nice and fast. Awesome. We need to keep the tummy tight, push the ground away, squeeze the legs, and then we're stable and ready to go for the next rep. Awesome, guys. Now it's time to move on to the strength speed complex using a descending time ladder. We've got three cycles. We're working from 40 to 30 to 20. We'll try and work continuously between exercises and have 20 seconds rest in between cycles. Let's go. So for each exercise, we need a strong focus on trying to sit the hips back, trying to keep the knees over the toes, and trying to really be explosive because this is strength speed. Looking good. Let's see what you've got in the tank, everybody. It's time to dig deep, test your fitness, test your power endurance, but not at the sacrifice of good technique. Excellent. Nice work on the sumos. Chest is high, shoulders are back, reaching the weights to the floor. Good job, Jonathan. Well done. That's it. Nice, strong leg alignment there. And we've got 2-1 time. Good. We ran over by a couple of seconds there. So we'll make it up on the next exercise. And 3-2-1 begin. Good job. Everybody stay super strong in your form and in your shape. Use the regression options if you need to. We could drop down to the knees if we want to. We could eliminate the jump here if we need to. And the sumo squat jump is looking good. Okay, Dream Team, it's time to move on to the speed strength complex. We are going to be using a constant rep protocol, but each exercise has a different number of reps. So it's still relatively simple in as far as we move from 12, 10, 8 and 6 through the exercises. We have two cycles and there are 30 seconds in between those cycles. Then we take it to 10, 8 and 6. Try to be sure to flex the elbows, bringing the chest slowly to the ground so that we decelerate the body weight. Good. Now your target is to try and bring the foot as close to the hand as possible. A regression is just to bring the foot back a little bit because it's just bringing that flexibility challenge in. So we work within our own limits. Powering off each leg, moving across the mat. Use the mat as a target. That's a great idea. Chest is high, powerful and reactive, quick on the floor. Imagine the ground is really hot. Okay, we're now moving on to complex number 5. This is power endurance. We are using a constant repetition protocol, and this is also effectively a race. And feet together, feet apart. Good. Reach the weights to the floor. We are now 1:30 in. Plank position. Split the feet, 1 foot in, and double taps. Let's go. Well done, guys. Remember, you can use each other to try and work off to make it competitive, but you are working against yourself. It's your own time you're looking to set and improve upon. Next week, we want to come back and beat that. Let's go, guys. We're almost there. I've got the clock ready. We've got our counter movement jump and our shuffle back. Beware of the weights, Jonathan. So move into your lane and shuffle back. Looking good, guys. Nice big explosive jump. Quick feet back to the start. Good work, Katie. Nice form. Complete every repetition. Keep going, guys. As soon as you finish, we'll stop the clock. Yeah. Okay, guys, you've worked really hard. It's time for our active recovery complex. So one cycle through, 45 seconds, using a similar format to the warm-up. Guys, let's form a line. So we will begin with our hurdle step, same as before, 45 seconds, let's begin. Try and just bring that range of movement into the hip circle and bring the pace down just a little bit, rather than jog back, walk back. Okay, let's go into the hip cradle and then nice long lunge, so it's more of a stretch. Hip cradle, and then next rep. Good stuff. You can use both hands, one to pull the leg in, one to push the knee down, if you want that increased rotation stretch of the hip. Awesome. We'll take it into a skip with an alternating arm raise. So nice high knees, but let's keep it relaxed as we move through that skipping action. And steady, slow walk back. Fantastic work, everybody. Well done. Looking forward to seeing you again next time. Let's see if we can improve upon some of those scores, in particular from our fitness challenge in the power endurance complex. Last 10 seconds, so time for one more lap through. And when you get to the end, KT, take a rest. Well done. Jonathan, and great work. Well done, everybody. We'll see you next time.